The United Nations Environment Programme in 2011 identifies 8 emergency measures which, from a duty of care point of view, warrant immediate action. The UN organization recommends that immediate steps must be taken to prevent existing contaminated sites from being secondary sources of ongoing contamination, while further risk assessments and investigations are undertaken for detailed planning of the cleanup of Ogoni land during a recommended transition phase.
The message here is that, yes, the situation is serious, but we are not at the same situation as in Fukushima in Japan or Chernobyl in Ukraine, where people had to be removed from the area. There is still life there, and there is still a possibility of fixing the problem. But the actions need to be taken now.
UNEP team says all sources of ongoing contamination must be brought to an end before the cleanup of the creeks, sediments, and mangroves can begin. The report recommends establishing 3 new institutions in Nigeria to support a comprehensive environmental restoration exercise. A proposed Ogoni Land Environmental Restoration Authority would oversee implementation of the study's recommendations and should be set up during a transition phase, which UNEP suggests should begin as soon as possible. A recommended integrated contaminated soil management center to be built in Ogoni land and supported by potentially hundreds of mini treatment centers. The report also recommends creating a center of excellence in environmental restoration in Ogoni land to promote learning and benefit other communities impacted by oil contamination in the Niger Delta and elsewhere in the world. Reforms of environmental government regulation, monitoring and enforcement, and improved practices by the oil industry are also recommended in the report. The authorities' activities should be funded by an environmental restoration fund for Ogoni land to be set up with an initial capital injection of $1 billion contributed by the oil industry and the government to cover the first 5 years of the cleanup project. 4 years after the United Nations report was released, the federal government finally approved $10 million to fast-track the cleanup exercise. UNEP in 2011 recommended $10 billion.
What is expected to be done has been simplified by the in-depth report of UNEP. They have been able to specify what needs to be done. And if you follow the recommendation keenly, you will see that the issues that are highlighted, once the commitment is there for the implementation, they will definitely achieve it. For example, in the area of the emergency measures, which has to do with the provision of alternative water sources to the people, that will go a long way in terms of improving what we call quality of life. And you know, quality of life is one of the goals of the macroeconomy. And so when you have good quality of life, when you have good hair care, when you have good housing, then your life expectancy will be very, very high. And that's one of the things that will be achieved in Ogoni by the alternative provision of water supply. Also, too, if you look at the area of the land contamination, cleaning up those land will make the land come back for agricultural use, which, you know, agriculture provides greater amount of employment in terms of labor intensiveness. So that will also provide employment generation in Ogoni. Apart from that, those land will now be able to provide output, and that will contribute greatly to the economic growth of the country, not just the economic growth of Ogoni.
For the Ogoni people, the latest action is an answer to their prayers and many years of struggle. Today, the people of Ogoni land complain of high mortality rate and low fertility. Their youths are restless and yearning for change, and quickly too.
Where we are now is called Nsisoken, which the UNEP report highlighted that the level of benzene in Nsisoken is above 900. So that's where we are now. That is the seat of the benzene area. And the residents around here, one, they don't have good water. We've been living with this before UNEP came in to conduct their report. And now the level of impotency in Ogale is very, very high. Death rate is also high. Now I can say vehemently that in our community, very rare, before you see somebody live up to 70 years.
What you have here is a monopump. From the use of this monopump brings highly benzenated water. Colorless water is not obtainable here. Odorless water is not obtainable here. From the color, you will see highly high contents of benzene. And from the odor, and this prompted the former administration of Right on Road to Michibika Metri to provide this community with water tanks like this. For young persons, the big talk is not what we need. Young persons from all the local government areas covered in the INEP report are ready. We can't continue living like this. We can't continue living on water as charity. We are ready, the manpower is ready. We need the training, we need the implementation to commence. And we thank President Buhari for the fast track measures, and we expect action immediately.